So this is the first experiment, mode characteristics of the reflex klystron oscillator. So the block diagram is here. First we have the klystron power supply, then reflex klystron oscillator, then isolator or attenuator, frequency meter, followed by diode detector and CRO. So same thing, we have the setup here. So this is the klystron power supply. This is the reflex klystron oscillator, followed by the isolator, then frequency meter, then the diode detector, then we have the CRO. So you can see that in this arrangement, first we have to switch on the klystron power supply.
So we have a procedure for this one. So first you switch on the on off switch, then you wait for 1 or 2 minutes, because this power supply is made up of devices,
so it will take some few minutes to turn it on. Now if you see this voltmeter and ammeter which is combined together, so we have more the readings that can be taken from this same meter. So the top one black is going to be the volt, and lower one the red is going to be the milliamps, that is current. So to select it, we have the selection knob. So this is going to be the selector knob, so that we can switch it off to beam voltage, then beam current and the repeller voltage. So you make this switch from the off position to beam voltage position, so that the voltage will be increased. It will be around 200 volts. And then after that, you put it in the current mode. Then you can see the current in this, so that will be always less than 20 milliamps. You make sure that it is less than 20 milliamps, otherwise you reduce the voltage. Then after that you switch it to the repeller voltage. Then you vary the modulation amplitude in such a way that you can get a square waveform, the CRO. Square waveform, you have to see the mode characteristics of the reflex klystron oscillator. So this is the tabular column, we have to fill it up actually. What are the things we have here is the repeller voltage in volt, relative power output, and the frequency of oscillation, that is to be, which can be seen from this reflex klystron power supply. Then the frequency can be noted from this frequency meter. Then the relative power output can be seen from this CRO. Reading and draw the graph, you will be getting a graph like this. So the first one is going to be the repeller voltage versus relative power output. The second one is going to be the repeller voltage versus the frequency of oscillation. So in the first one, the repeller voltage starts from zero. It goes on increasing. This is the first mode. Then it is decreasing to zero. Then it is going to be again increasing and going to a maximum value, then decreasing to zero. So like that, you will be getting some number of modes. Here we have taken 3 modes. So if you see that the first mode will be having an amplitude which is less, then it is greater, it is still greater. So we have to take a mode like this. So now we have here the starting point of the first mode is zero. Now I am going to vary the repeller voltage here, so that the mode will be increased. So we have to take the different points here. So first I am taking the midpoint of the first mode. That is, this is the first mode we are going to have it. In the first mode, I am going to take the midpoint, the maximum point, then again the midpoint in the trailing edge of the first mode. Similarly, same thing we are going to do it for the next 2 modes. The midpoint, the maximum point, the midpoint of the second mode, then again the midpoint, maximum point, and the midpoint of the third mode. So first we have set for the first mode, the midpoint we have taken it here. So first we have to see the amplitude, then frequency, then the repeller voltage. So the repeller voltage, we can see it from here. So the repeller voltage is here, it is going to be, so the top one we have to see the black letters, So it is going to be from 0 to 100. It is lying in between this. So it is around 40 volt. So we have to note it down here as in the repeller voltage, the 40 volt. Then after that, we have to see the relative power output. Relative power output, you have to see the magnitude here. Okay, you have to, you should not vary this amplitude hereafter. For the entire experiment, it should be in the same division. Only you have to take the magnitudes here. So if you see the magnitude, you just bring down to any one of the line. So now it is going to be 3 divisions. It is 0.6 it is going to be, because the from here to here it is going to be 1 division. So it is 3 divisions we have. So that is going to be 0.6. So the amplitude is 0.6. So we have to note it down here. First the 50, then the 0.6, then the frequency. Frequency we have to see it from here. So we have to tune this frequency meter. So while tuning this frequency meter, you start from either from the bottom or from the top. Don't go in the midway. Okay, you start from the bottom. So you just turn this frequency meter bit by bit. So it is going to be slowly tuning this one. Don't go fast, because while tuning this one, we have to see the dip here in this frequency CRO. Okay, you did not see this one. So you just tune this one in a bit by bit manner, slowly, and you see the CRO. Where you get the dip, you just note down the reading from the frequency meter. So now I am going to move this frequency meter bit by bit, and I am going to see it here, the frequency. See that here we are getting a dip. So there is a reduction in the output, is going to be called as a dip. So now we have got the dip, and keep it in this position and see that what is the frequency you have got it now. So you know that I already told you. So in this frequency meter we have more numbers, but in this you have to take the numbers in this, in between these two lines, the horizontal lines, and we have a vertical line here. From this vertical line, where it is standing, you have to take the reading. So now it is slightly behind the 9.36. So it is we have to take the adjacent readings, and you have to calculate it. What is the reading? And you have to note it in the frequency of oscillation in gigahertz. So you remember that it is going to be in gigahertz, okay, the frequency. So now the first reading is over. So after taking this reading, you have to dilute in this one, because we will be always getting the values which is nearer. So if you keep it in the same position, the same value will be obtained, so that you tune it. Then after that, you go to the repeller voltage, which is going to be varied in such a way that you will be getting the maximum output in this. So you got the maximum output of the first mode. Then again, you note down this reading. So then the reading is going to be 1 division, so it is going to be 1. Then again, you vary this frequency meter. So the frequency meter is varied in such a way that you will be getting a dip here. You just watch for the dip by varying the frequency meter bit by bit. So here again we got the dip. So now you again note it down from this frequency meter. What is the reading? You have got it. So now it is between 3.6 and 3.8. So you exactly calculate it and note it down in the record. Again, after that you vary the repeller voltage. Okay, then before that you detune this one, so that we will be getting the square waveform again, and you vary the repeller voltage to get the midpoint in the trailing edge. So now we are getting half of this, that is, you note down the relative power output. It is 0.4 divisions. Again, you vary this frequency meter so that you will be getting a dip. you see for the dip here. Again, you got a dip. So now down this reading from the frequency meter. Now it is between 9.4 and 9.42. So note down this reading. So now, like this, they have taken the reading. So this is for the first mode. They have taken three readings: the midpoint, the maximum point, then again the midpoint. Then similarly, you do it for the next two modes. So if you vary this bipolar voltage now, then you will be getting the variation in the output. So the same thing is repeated for two more modes, and the experiment will be over. To draw the graph, you take the ordinary graph and you draw this. You will be getting three modes and correspondingly the oscillations for the three modes.